Hello and welcome back to the channel. So this was shared with me by one of our brothers. So I wanted to go ahead and chime in on this particular topic because what I saw, I am in full agreement with the brother who shared this clip with me. I'm not going to show you the clip. I'm just going to kind of scan through it a bit. The clip is just too much, family. But anyway, it is a Black Lady Sketch Show. And it's the season 4 intro. So the viewer or the brother who shared this with me said that is such a disappointment. And I absolutely agree with him on this. This is the kind of thing that is just running rampant in the so-called Black community. And we've just gotten comfortable being in this fallen downward state. The state of separation from the Most High. And we justify any and everything for fame and fortune. The Bible says, what would it profit a man or a woman to gain the whole world and lose their soul? So the brother says, Sister Deborah, as a brother who fully understands that the brother as the head have led the bodies in error, this made me in sadness. The intro for the Black Lady Sketch Show shows season 4 is just such a disappointment. Normally when I see black anything in regards to movies and shows, I go in the opposite direction because I know they are going to push poison in a beautiful vase, still poison. But I said, let me just see and not be like that toward the sisters. I went through 3 seasons not really finding anything funny, even finding much funny, but this intro for season 4 is just sad. No other all black woman shows, living single, girlfriend, sister, half and half, etc. The shows came on with the sisters dressed and handling themselves far from raunchy. This is the raunchiest intro I have ever seen. We will never see the other nations doing this. Then I believe the first skit, they mocked the birth of JC. I wish the brothers would get an understanding and lead better than they have. Okay, so that's what the brother said concerning this thing, a Black Lady Sketch Show. So I am going to thumb through it a bit just to give you an idea of what he is talking about. What they are showing is definitely raunchy. I mean, you can already see how they're dressed. And see, most people, they would say, what's wrong with this? Because this generation have gotten so far away from what's right and what's holy in the sight of the Most High that they look at this like it's wholesome. And they look at you like you're crazy for thinking that something is out of place with this. So let me just pull it up on the screen. Like I said, I'm not going to show the whole video. I'm just going to kind of scan through it a bit so you can see what the brother was talking about. It's right here on YouTube. Let me scoot that up just a little bit. It's called A Black Lady Sketch Show Season 4 Intro, and it shows you how far we have fallen as a people. We were commanded to be the light of the world, but that is not what we are seeing. That is not what we are seeing when you look at something like this is actually a step backwards. So let me go ahead with the scanning through so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, so some would say that's harmless. Okay, but watch this. Okay, okay, so they're showing the leg uncrossing. Okay, and as the leg hits the foot hits the floor, you see this coloration coming from in between her legs, an explosion of coloration. Okay, and then she's puffing on something. Okay, I don't know what it is. It looks like a strange cigar or whatever. I don't know. Anyway, that's the first lady. And then she blows out, yeah, there you go, a poof of smoke and she chokes. Okay. So with the second lady, here we go. Here she is. She throws her leg up over the chair, and the same coloration comes from between her legs. You see? This is really making the daughters of Zion look just terrible. And like I said, I know a lot of times people will come for you when you say things, when you point out the obvious about this kind of stuff. They'll come for you like, what is your problem, right? They will come for you like, you are the one with the problem. But then our folk want to pretend like they don't know nor understand why our young girls are out of control. Some of them act like dogs in the heat. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. It is what it is. See, most people are used to the Christian version of things. You can't clean the fish before you catch it. The Bible says, come as you are. You have to let people feel their way through. And I mean, just all kinds of things are being said. So anyway, here's the next one. Same thing. From between the legs, you see the coloration just bursting out. This is, I'm sorry, y'all, it's despicable. And look, and then she throws up the middle finger. Here's the next one. Opening the legs, and there's the burst of coloration coming from between the legs. And so I can understand why the brother was just totally disappointed by this. I mean, we should all be disappointed in this. Look at all of this. This, it's a shame, y'all. It is a shame that this is what our people have come to. We were supposed to be the light of the world, and that is not what we are seeing. We see wickedness on full display. And folk don't want you to say nothing to them. Don't say a word to me about what I'm doing. As a matter of fact, if you're an older or middle-aged woman, they will simply chalk it up and say that you're jealous of the younger women. That is a smokescreen. That is an excuse. That is deflection. That is wickedness, because they don't want you to call out the wickedness. They will say that the middle age, I've seen videos like that. As a matter of fact, there was one where a brother was actually calling out the younger women, right? It was kind of funny. I meant to share it. I hope I can find it again. Whoever shared it with me, if you see this, it would be awesome if you can reshare it with me. I didn't get a chance to speak on it. But there was a middle-aged brother who was calling out young women for basically dissing middle-aged or older women as if they're supposedly jealous of younger women. And this brother was like, no, that ain't what's going on. You know, he says that he would take him a seasoned, knowledgeable, mature woman any day over the youth, right? Of course, some men do desire the youth. That's their prerogative, right? We shared many years ago a situation that we were aware of. When we lived in Michigan, there was a person we used to do business with. He was a black brother who was in real estate. We were in real estate. That's how we ended up crossing paths, because of our mutual interest in real estate investing. And so once we got close to the brother, we found out that he was married to a young black woman. Now, mind you, his first wife had passed away. He had adult children that some of them were actually older than the second wife that he married. Now, one day he got into conversation with us about something. Now, at the time, he was older than my husband and myself. I was 27 at the time. My husband was around 36, 37 years old. And this guy was already in his late 40s. So he was approaching 50. But what I found interesting, he was married to someone in their 20s, but he was so mesmerized by someone else. He had met an older, mature black woman that he was doing business with. And he was so struck by this older black woman that he was doing business with that he got into conversation with us, and he was telling us how smart she is, and she's so easy to talk to. She's so fun to talk to. And I think he was not venting, but just wanted us to know what he saw in this woman, although he was married to a young 20-something-year-old. He told us that his wife, all she wants to do is spend his money and shop all the time because the brother was well off. He owned a lot of real estate. I believe the vehicle he drove around in was a Bentley. He had all kinds of conversion vans. He had all kinds of vehicles. So this was a brother who was well paid. But I'm not going to say he made a mistake, but he messed around and married a younger woman. And he said they had absolutely nothing in common. So when he finally does meet this woman that's closer to his age, he was so blown away by her that you can hear the regret in his voice, having married someone who he had nothing in common with. So most of the time, I'm not going to say all, but most of the time, those kinds of marriages where someone who's, you know, almost 50 marrying someone in their 20s, a lot of times those marriages are about sex. And y'all know I'm telling the truth, right? So I said all that to say this. Just because a middle-aged, that is a loud helicopter. It sounds like it is literally on top of us. The building is shaking. Gee whiz. Whew. Huh, okay. Sometimes military copters go by in the area. Sorry for that interruption. It was shaking, literally. I was shaking. But anyway, my husband just said something on the walkie-talkie. He said that was crazy. Yeah, I know, baby. I'm broadcasting and, or should I say recording, and I can feel the building shaking. Anyway, let me get back to it. I'm going to turn my walkie-talkie off now. Sorry about that, family. Sorry about that. Okay, anyway, I was almost done with this anyway, but it's very interesting that many times there's this thought that older women are looking down on younger women, but what we're trying to do in many cases is bring correction to this type of behavior, and most of them don't want to hear nothing you got to say. You can't talk to them about anything, right? You can't talk to them about anything, and it's really sad that this is how it is. But you know what? At the end of the day, the Most High is going to have the last say so. As our people continue to go on this downward spiral, the Most High, He's going to continue to pull out that spiritual belt. Yes, He is. Because we were supposed to be the light of the world, not the darkness. Okay, y'all, I'm done with this video. Chop it up in the comment section. As always, keep it tight and keep it right. But until next time, I'm out.
We hope you like today's topic. Please leave your comments below. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, share it, like this video, and with that, we're out.
Be sure to ring the bell to be notified of new uploads on this channel, and also comment, share, like, and subscribe.